Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to part 5 of Let's Play Diddy Kong Racing. In our last part, we finished off Dino Domain, except for the trophy race, and we also defeated Taj in the second of his racing challenges, and we started the second world, Snowflake Mountain. Now we are 15 balloons through the game, and it's time to continue our adventure. First, we're going to call Taj over here, so he can change our vehicle.
Hello, friend.
And I'm sure, as you've noticed, out in the distance, one-fourth of the whiz pig head is, has changed. That shows us our progress through this game so far. We have to get 3 more pieces of the whiz pig amulet, and that whiz pig head will actually open its mouth, and we will have to fly inside to take on whiz pig. But that won't be for a while. For the moment, we will focus on Snowflake Mountain. And as you can see, we've already finished Everfrost Peak, which we did in the last part, and now it's time to do the other 4 races and then race against the boss. Hopefully we'll be able to do all of that in this part. And we will start with Walrus Cove, so here we go. And right away is one of my favorite level pieces, set pieces in the entire game. Loops. This is one of 2 levels that has a loop in it that gives you a boost throughout the loop. So yeah, this is... But other than that loop, I'm kind of in the middle of the road about this course. I like it, but there are some parts of it I don't like. Like, especially this section, the ice that you can fall into. It's really weird. It doesn't behave like actual ice. You don't slide on it. You bounce off of it. It behaves more like a trampoline than anything else. I always found that kind of weird, but... Eh. Video game logic. What can you do? And, wow, we're kind of breezing through this. I said, yeah, this game, it is a rather easy game overall, but don't let that fool you. I said overall. There are a couple sections, more than a couple really, that are actually kind of difficult later in the game. Like I've been saying in the past couple of parts, this, just because we're breezing through everything right now, doesn't mean this game's always going to be as easy as it's being right now. If that were the case, I wouldn't be doing an LP of this. Anyway, we're approaching the final stretch. And Walrus Cove is done for the time being. And at the very end, after I win, I hit a trap. Eh. We don't need to see that. Okay, Walrus Cove done. Now for Snowball Valley. Okay, here we go. This is the third race course, and it has a very interesting gimmick. Yes, snowballs. As if the title of the level didn't give it away. We have to dodge snowballs, although they're actually pretty easy to avoid. The only way you can really get smushed by them is if you intentionally drive into them. Really, that's really the only way. And this level isn't that bad, except with the snowballs that I just talked about, but the silver coin challenge is a little bit of, does have a bit of a trick to it. But we'll worry about that later. Right, get through here. And another race for the record books. And again, for the second race in a row, I hit a sludge after I've won. That's really weird. For the two consecutive races, after I've crossed the finish line and won, I've ended up hitting a sludge trap. That's really weird. But anyway, it's time to move on to the fourth race course of Snowflake Mountain. One of my favorite race courses. Probably my favorite in this world. Although the silver coin challenge for this one can be a little bit of a pain as well. No kidding. Whoa! Wow, somebody shot off a homing missile and it didn't hit me. Wow. What are the odds of that? I mean, I heard the thing coming toward me, I was like, oh crap. And it whizzed right by me. Must have been a dud. No, that was really weird. You'd think it would have hit me. I guarantee you any other time it would have hit me. But I digress. Probably better it didn't hit me, because I would have been like, oh my god! You know, I wouldn't have freaked out, but I really wouldn't have been happy. Whoa! Nearly avoided a spiked bomb, which is the power-up from the sludge attack. Oh wow, I can't believe I just did that. Sorry ladies and gentlemen, I kind of blanked out for a second. I tend to do that sometimes. Okay. I do not need to be doing stupid stuff now. It's way too early in the LP. And again, there's never a good time to do stupid stuff in an LP. Alright, all the races are done so far, you know what that means. Boss time. Here we go.
Well done. Now I challenge you to a race.
This is Bluey, the walrus, and we're racing in the hovercraft, the worst race vehicle ever created, and I did not get the boost start, so gonna have to overcome that. Look out, look out, look out. Don't want to get too close to him. And I missed the blue balloon. Yeah, earlier in an earlier part I called them purple balloons. That was incorrect. They are blue. And I've actually taken the lead on him now. Let's see if I can hold it. If I'm lucky, I won't need to use any balloons. But I'm going to grab a blue one just in case. You never know with me playing a game. Anything can happen. Anything. But now I got a pretty good lead on him now. Get a second balloon and let's just shoot it off. Rub it in his face. Yes, sir, Mafia Walrus.
I've got something special for you.
Alright, so We've beaten Bluey the Walrus for the first challenge, and now we will be able to do the Silver Coin challenge for Snowflake Mountain. But we're not going to do that right now in this part. We're going to call it a part here. This has been part 5 of Let's Play Diddy Kong Racing for the N64. Ultimate Lifeform RB out for now. See you folks in the next part.